Take my money.
Got something I can hang on to for you?
Okay, I'm good to go.
Get out. Time to go pick up another car. See, that would be pretty punny if I said time to go pick up another truck. Ha 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 ha. Perfect. It's so smart. Down here. Car appears. Hello, car. You and I are going to become acquainted. Oh, sorry about that window. Running out of things to talk about, chat. Oh, right into the wall. I wonder what has to be this specific about. If there's even a reason. Foods are super common and so they don't stand out. Could be a possibility.
I'm in Point Verdun and I need a new set of wheels.
On it, lad. Just getting her warmed up.
Don't you hit me. I did that Thursday too. It resulted in the same thing, me crashing into a wall.
Yeah, we've got a report of a car being stolen at Irish Point.
use any units at time. Maybe go take a shave it.
Did I get out? I didn't get out.
Repeat, abandoned search. Return to patrols.
Thank you. The robotical chicken, is that how you say that? Yeah, I never played the Mafia series, and when they released the Definitive Edition and put it on sale on Xbox, I was like, yeah, I'll take that. Well, thanks for the follow. I apologize if I didn't speak to you quickly enough. Oh, you're not there. Yeah, I don't have a really good setup for seeing chat, unfortunately, so I tend to have to look over. And I don't always look over
good
in time.
Good to see you. Come on in. I'm a man who honors his agreements, and this right here is your full cut.
Sorry, bear with me for a second. Okay, sorry about that.
Well, with a lot of regular folk missing their wheels, the brothers back in Belfast really appreciate your help.
Okay. So I can't do any more of that. I can go steal the semi truck. So we'll do that. I think that's probably going to be the last option thing we can do, and then we'll go back to some more story-oriented things. So, back to personal stuff. I have had a problem for a while now of...
I'm in Point Verdun, and I'm...
Just gonna take a squirt, and I'll get her out to you.
That's disgusting. I've not been I've never been diagnosed as narcoleptic, and I don't think I have. But I will say this. There are times where I have no idea. Like, I would just basically, I don't want to say lose consciousness, that sounds wrong. It's almost like I just drift off out of nowhere. And I think that's what just happened. I think I drifted off for like a couple of minutes, maybe. Because I looked up in the game and I didn't really know what was going on. Now, that's not a really good thing for a streamer, but it is what it is. I'm pretty sure when that person came into chat, that's what was going on. I feel really bad because I didn't respond, and I totally would have. Actually just sent that person a whisper explaining that, sorry, I didn't see the chat, come back if you want to chat and all that stuff. Because it's the first person who's talked in the chat that wasn't telling me that the sound was bad or something. So I'm sorry that I missed that, but I'm pretty sure I was actually, like, I don't know how to put it, unconscious, blacked out, asleep. But that's not the first time that's happened. It's not the first time it's happened when I'm streaming. It's certainly not the first time it's happened in my life in general. So yeah, I don't know. It's never been so bad that I felt like I needed to go to a doctor about it. But that might change. Like I said, I don't think I'm narcoleptic. Because it doesn't happen to me on my phone standing. It's like this, only when I'm seated. I also at one point had a problem where my blood pressure would just drop out of nowhere. We could never figure out what the problem was. I went to doctor after doctor, specialists, checking. I went to neurologists, I went to heart doctors. I just recently went to an ear, nose, throat doctor. And nobody can figure out why it happens. And it went away for about 4 years and then came back this year. That's even more of a mystery as to why that happened. So, I don't know if the two are related or not, but it's kind of odd. That could be my niche, you know? If it turns out I have narcolepsy, I could be the narcoleptic gamer, but I don't know how interesting that is. Watching a guy who might fall asleep in the middle of the stream. Anyway, back to the game. Like I said, I have no issue sharing personal stuff. I'm not going to tell you where I live, but, you know, as far as... just things about me. Steal the semi-truck. What semi-truck? Where's the semi? What? I don't see a semi-truck. Is it just me? Did this mission not really start? What? Okay, this is odd. Trying to figure out how to get to that junction box. Do I have to get wet to get to it? Maybe so. Hope there's no gators over here. Seems simple enough, except for there's no truck. Let's, before I restart the game, let's change to a different objective. And then we change back and see if that changes anything, if that makes a difference. Yeah. Huh. That's really a puzzle. Okay, well, looks like we're gonna have to quit and restart because there should be a truck there, I'm pretty sure. I don't know how I steal a truck if there's not a truck. Continue. I feel like this happened once before. Maybe I'm wrong. Where we had to quit the game and restart it for something to trigger to load in. I can't think of what it was. I know one time we had an invisible objective. One of the weed pickups was invisible. That was interesting. Oh, yeah, we did. There was a... Sorry, tapping on the table. There was really... There was a... The when we first started the Burke stuff, the thing about going to talk to Nikki didn't trigger at first. Because I couldn't figure out, I was like, okay, what do I do now? Because there was no objectives. And we figured out, oh, it should have given you one, but for some reason it didn't. And we restarted and went fine. So hopefully that'll be the same thing here. But it's important that we have to drive all the way from here to get there again. But one thing I will say about that, whatever the condition is, that I don't have a name for, it never happens when I'm driving. Even though that's a seated position, I don't know why. I don't know why any of it happens. But just in case you were curious, that no, it's never happened while I've just driving. That would be really bad. And I think at that point I'd have to go get a check. That's not something you can just be like, oh well. So I may occasionally lose consciousness when I drive. Big deal. Also, do you think I should put in my titles that I'm playing on hard mode? Like, is that something that is significant enough to point out? It probably is. I didn't really think about that until just now. When that other person said that they were also playing this game. And I was like, well, I wonder, like, what the difference is. Like, what my playthrough versus his play, his or her playthrough was like. First thing I thought of was, are they playing on hard? Hard difficulty level. Not that I'm not making a judgment either way, I'm just curious. One of the reasons, I think I've talked about this in the previous stream, but one of the reasons why I play on hard mode is because I feel like it makes you strategize. But another reason that I play on hard mode is because I feel like I get more for my money. And this goes back to the dollars you spend on entertainment. If I play on hard mode and it takes me an extra 5 hours to finish a game and it's still fun, that's the fourth part, then that game is more valuable. Semi still isn't here. Whereas, you know, if you play on easy mode and you just go through it with no problem, you didn't get as much value, theoretically. Well, some people may disagree with that, that's fine. But for me, and I won't say I'm a tight budget, I can pretty much buy a game if I want to buy a game.